Hello students, in today's video we are going to understand what are the basics of set followed by two methods in which we can write down a set. So to understand what is a set, let me give you two examples. Collection of days of a week and collection of colors of rainbow. I want you to think the answer for this. Okay, so I'm sure you must be confident about this answer, and so is Arav. He seems to be very happy and very sure about the answer, and obviously we all are. So the answer for the first one is all the days of a week from Monday to Sunday. Okay, and for the second one, the answer is violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red, that is Vibgyor. Okay, so if you understand these two questions very properly, and if I ask this question to any one of you, maybe Arav or any other student watching this video, the answer is definite. What is that? There are 7 days in a week and there are 7 colors in a rainbow. Okay, so let me ask you two more questions, that is the collection of easy subjects and the collection of your favorite food. Okay, so I think so most of you must be slightly confused about this, and so is Arjun. Why? Let us discuss that. So when I ask you easy subjects, so what do you mean by easy? Now for Arav, maths must be easy. For Arjun, science is easy. For some other student, history is going to be easy. For some other student, geography is going to be easy. Okay, so when I say collection of easy subjects, that is a very subjective question. Means what? The answer will change according to person to person. Okay, the same thing is for the collection of favorite food. Arav likes Chinese, Arjun likes Italian, and you must be liking all other varieties of food. So again, this particular question is quite subjective. So for the collection of easy subjects and for the collection of favorite food, we do not have a specific answer like the first two examples. Okay, so from this, what we understand is a set is nothing but a collection of well-defined or distinct elements. So let me give you few more examples so that the concept is cleared very properly, students. So the next is a set of whole numbers. Okay, so we all know what are called as whole numbers. Whole numbers are the numbers which starts from 0 and it goes on. So it is an infinite. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Let's see the next example, that is the collection of vowels in English alphabet, and the answer is A, E, I, O, U. Okay, let's see one more example, the set of even prime number. Students, understand this example very properly. There is only one number which is even as well as prime, and the number is 2. Okay, one more example, set of quadrilaterals. So let us write down all the name of the quadrilaterals, that is parallelogram, rectangle, rhombus, square, trapezium and kite. So these four examples, what do you see, students? Okay, they are having a defined elements in them, whether it is whole numbers, vowels, even prime number or quadrilaterals. Okay, so the collection of well-defined distinct elements is called as a set. Okay, so if you have understood this very properly, students, let us start with methods of writing a set. So the first method is called as a roster form. It is also called as listing form. So the name justifies, listing form means what? Let's see the first example, set of prime numbers less than 15. So we are writing the set or the list of all the prime numbers which are less than 15, and see how do we write down a set. Okay, I'm writing A equal to capital A. So remember, first thing, a set is always given by a capital letter. You can use any letters. I've used A over here. Equal to, we write down the answer in curly brackets. So that is 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. So whatever you write down inside a curly bracket, those are called as elements of a set. Whether it is numbers, alphabets or whatever, we call them as elements of a set. Let us take one more example. Set of letters in the word corona. Okay, now suppose if I write my answer as capital B equal to, in curly brackets I'm writing the answer C O R O N A, my this answer is going to be wrong. Why? If you see the elements carefully, I have repeated O twice. Okay, so always remember one thing, students, whenever you're writing elements of a set, okay, elements should not be repeated. So my correct answer is B equals to C O R N A. Okay, so this is the correct answer. Remember, elements are not to be repeated when you're writing in listing form. Okay, let us take one more example, that is set of squares of natural numbers. Okay, we all know what are called as natural numbers, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. We are writing the squares of these numbers. Okay, so your answer is going to be, I've used capital C to indicate the set, C equals to 1, 4, 9, 16, 25 and so on. So students, this is how we write down a particular set in a listing form. Okay, so you have to just write down all the elements in the answer. Okay, now with this, let us take the second method. Okay, so the second method is called as a set builder form. It is also called as rule method. Okay, now understand this method very properly. Now let me take the first example, that is A equals to A, E, T. Now students, using these alphabets A, E and T, you have to form a word. Okay, so let's see how do we write down in the set builder form. A equals to X, such that X is a letter in the word T. Now instead of T, you can even write the word eat. Okay, so both are correct. Now understand how I have written. Again, I'll repeat. A equals to X. Now instead of X, you can write any other alphabet. Then I'm putting a vertical sign. So that vertical sign means such that. Okay, so this is how we write down capital A equals to, in curly brackets, X, vertical line means such that. What is X? X is a letter in the word T. Okay, let us take one more example, students. B equals to 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Can you guess what are these numbers? Yes, these numbers are nothing but odd numbers. So how do we write down? Let's see. B equals to X. Again, we have a vertical line such that X. Then I'm putting that sign which looks like E. But students, actually, it is not E. It is nothing but a Greek letter epsilon. Okay. The meaning of this particular Greek letter is belongs to. So instead of writing belongs to every time, we have to just put that symbol means belongs to. Okay. So let us come back to the answer. X such that X belongs to capital N. Now remember this, students, capital N is always used to notify natural numbers. Okay, so X belongs to natural numbers, right? But we are not writing all natural numbers, we are writing only odd numbers. So we are writing X such that X belongs to natural number. But what is X? X is an odd number less than 10. Okay, we are writing all odd numbers, natural odd numbers less than 10. So you have to specify, okay, that the numbers are less than 10. Let's see the third example. C equals to 8 comma minus 8. Now here I am writing two opposite answers, plus 8 minus 8. Okay, so what will be the set builder form? Let's see. C equals to X. Again, I'm writing in the same way. X such that X belongs to capital I. Now capital I indicates integers. Now why I'm writing integers over here, students? Because we know that integers have positive numbers, negative numbers as well as zero. So since I have minus 8 over here, I'm using integers. Okay, comma X equals to square root of 64. Okay, now students, you have to remember this. Okay, whenever you take a square root of a perfect square, okay, we always have two answers. So square root of 64 is not only 8, it is also minus 8. So suppose if I am supposed to find square root of 25, so I'm not going to write down only 5, I'm going to write down plus 5 and minus 5. Okay students, I hope you have understood the basics of set and both the methods of writing it. Thank you so much.